after the presentation. The topic for today's webinar is Improvement of Storage, Stability and Productivity of Rice Through Genetic Engineering by Dr. Deepak Gayan. Dr. Deepak Gayan is an assistant professor at the Central University of Rajasthan. He received his PhD with an excellent background in biotechnology from the University of Calcutta under the guidance of Professor S. K. Datta. He gainfully combined his expertise in the area of molecular biology, particularly nutritional genomics, with the techniques of cell biology and made significant progress in stress-responsive pathways in plants. He then moved to the National Institute of Plant Genome Research, NIPGR, in New Delhi as a DBG Research Associate. Dr. Gayan was associated with proteomics and functional genomics work for understanding stress tolerance in plants. He has published several research papers in reputed international journals. Dr. Gayan is the recipient of a prestigious national award, the INSA Young Scientist of 2017 and the NASI Young Scientist of 2018, based on his significant scientific contributions. In 2018, Dr. Gayan was also selected as a Fulbright postdoc fellow at Cornell University in the United States. I now request Dr. Gayan to start his talk. Share your screen with us. Thank you.
Okay. Is it visible?
Yes, visible. Okay.
Am I audible to all of you?
Yes.
Very good morning to all of you. I would like to thank to all BioEngine members, especially Dr. Subhabrata Mojumdar. I got the invitation from him. Today I'm going to present, I will be talking about my work, the improvement of storage stability and productivity of rice through genetic engineering. Why it is important, we should know about this one, the storage stability and productivity, very much important to in nutritional quality as well as the yield. Now I'm coming to the outline of my presentation. Outline of my presentation is mainly divided into two parts. The first part is the reduction of post-harvest loss of crop, and second is the development of the stress tolerant plant. And these both show are very much important to ensure the food productivity, ensure the food security in the near future. First of all, I would like to tell about the reduction of post-harvest loss, and then I will come about the development of stress tolerant plant. Before going to the talk, I would like to introduce about the rice. What is the rice? We should know rice is the second largest mode cereal crop in the world. The rice is cultivated about the 113 countries all over the world. It provides about 27% of dietary energy and 20% of the dietary protein. People in the developing country have to depend on the rice as a major energy source. What is the history of the rice? The rice actually originated in the China. After that, it was spread over the Japan, European country, Africa, and different American country. We should know the global importance of the rice. Rice is a staple food which is consumed half of the world population. People in the developing country have to depend on the rice as a major energy source. Rice produce about the provide around the 76% of the calorie production in the Southeast Asia. According to the International Rice Research Center, rice production should be increased by 114 million tons by 2035. So we should improve the rice grain quality as well as the nutritional quality to ensure the food security. If you see that China is the major producer of the rice production. China produce about 30% of the total production, where India produce around 22% of the world rice production, and Burma, Philippines, Thailand, Vietnam, Bangladesh also contribute the rice production. According to the International Rice Station, Rice Research Station, in ERI, the rice production should be increased by 114 million tons by 2035 to ensure the food security, world food security. If you see the global food security is very much important for the 21st century. There was a paper was published in the PLOS One. They reported that the rice production should be increased by 60 to 110% to feed the entire population by 2050. According to their result, they have shown that the rice yield should be increased by 2.5% per year to increase the goal. So if you see the graph, not only the rice, maize, rice, wheat, soybean, all these crops, the production yield should be increased double to meet the global requisition by 2050. So now I'm coming first to the reduction of the post-harvest loss of the crop. Nutritional quality and viability deterioration is the major problem. It has been shown that about 1/3 of the food is lost due to poor post-harvest technology. The extent of deterioration is dependent on the both moisture content and temperature content during the storage process. According to the thumb rule, it was observed that around 50% of the rice seed life destroyed with increase in 1% moisture content or 5 degree increase in the temperature increase. If you see that in the developing country, their post-harvest technology is not very well. So in our country, rice generally stored in the house condition where temperature and moisture is not maintained properly. But in the developing countries, that due to high post-harvest technology, they generally store the proper environmental temperature control condition. But this is very cost-effective. This is not possible for the farmer. So we need to think about the alternative way to reduce the post-harvest loss of the rice. If you see the relative humidity and temperature and moisture content graph, the relative humidity, moisture content, and temperature all are related to the seed quality and viability. If you see the moisture relative humidity is increasing 50% to 91%, and if you see that with increasing temperature, increasing that row and moisture content of the rice seed are increasing. If you see that with increasing temperature, with increasing humidity as well as the temperature increasing, the moisture content of the rice seed increase. If you see here, generally rice seed moisture remains around 11.8%, this is safe, but beyond that it is become unsafe. If you see this region is safe, but this region is not safe. Rice is generally cultivated in the tropical country where moisture and temperature is very high. If you don't store properly, then the moisture content of the rice seed will increase and it will deteriorate the nutritional quality and viability of the rice seed. We need to think about the post-harvest technology. What is the post-harvest technology? This is one type of technology which is required after the storage process. It is very much related, which is very much important. The developing countries, they have the proper post-harvest technology, but in our country, we don't have the proper post-harvest technology. If this post-harvest technology is related to the food safety, nutritional quality, better storage, protection from pest, reduce the quality, and better marketing value. If you see the circle, there is the production, post-harvest, and marketing. These three is related to each other. If the production is high, but the post-harvest technology is poor, then marketing value will be low. So in that case, if the production is good, post-harvest technology is good, then marketing value of this grain will be good. So it is interconnected to each other. So we need to think about the post-harvest technology in our country. But the problem is that if we find out of the alternative way, we can avoid the post-harvest technology. So now, what is the lipoxygenase? Lipoxygenase is one of the important enzymes which remains in the plant. If you see the lipoxygenase, there is two types of lipoxygenase enzymes. One is the 9-lipoxygenase, another is the 13-lipoxygenase. This linoleic acid is the substrate for the lipoxygenase enzyme. It follows the two pathways. One is the 9 pathway, another is the 13 pathway. It depends on the oxygenation of the double bond. If oxygen attack from this side, it go to the 9-lipoxygenase pathway. If oxygen occur in the 13 carbon, it will go the 13-lipoxygenase pathway. Lipoxygenase has a huge role in the seed germination, seed storage, vegetative growth, wounding attack, pathogen attack, all this inflammation has a very major role in the plant system. If you see the we are in particularly interested about the seed lipoxygenase. If you see this paper, see it as a soybean, pea, chickpea, kidney bean, broad bean, lentils, lupin, maize, rice, wheat, all this crop has the lipoxygenase enzymes, and they have different type of lipoxygenase, LOX1, LOX2, LOX3, depending upon the oxygenation of this lipoxygenase enzyme. If you see here, you can easily understand what is the LOX1, because it is a 13 LOX. In case of LOX2, both 13 LOX and 9 LOX is equivalent, but in the LOX3, only the 9 lipoxygenase, follow the 9 lipoxygenase pathway. We are actually interested about the lipoxygenase of rice. Rice seed content three types of lipoxygenase enzymes, LOX1, LOX2, and LOX3. It has been observed that the among these LOX isomer, LOX3 remains in the rice seed content is very much. Apart from that, if you see the different paper, but the lipoxygenase has also the negative effect during the storage process of the rice. Because if you see this, all these papers, they have mentioned the rice seed, which has the low lipoxygenase activity, the storage stability and nutritional quality, storage stability and viability is high. So we need to think about the storage quality and viability of the rice seed. I have already discussed the rice seed has the three types of LOX enzymes, LOX1, LOX2, and LOX3. According to the Suzuki et al. 1990, that they have mentioned the LOX3 is the major component of the rice seed. If you see, now this is the rice seed, this is embryo, and this is the endosperm. This is the hull layer. In this layer, the lipoxygenase remains in the outer layer of the rice seed. Rice generally cultivated in the tropical country where the moisture and temperature is very high. During the storage process, the lipoxygenase enzyme, in presence of linoleic acid, the substrate produces huge amount of reactive oxygen species. And this reactive oxygen species actually involved in the cell death and nutritional quality, so that with increasing temperature, the lipoxygenase enzymes activated and produced reactive oxygen species and deteriorated the nutritional quality and viability of the rice seed. So we need to, if we increase the nutritional quality and viability of the rice seed, if we downregulate the lipoxygenase enzyme, then we can maintain the storage stability and the viability of the rice seed. To understand the how the lipoxygenase enzymes actually involved in the seed quality deterioration, for that purpose, we collected some of the local rice cultivar, Pusha Sugandhi, IR64, Hitish, IAT101, and CR1018, this variety. After that, collecting this fresh seed, we store the seed artificially. Why it is artificially? Because we keep in the temperature 42 degrees centigrade, and humidity was 84%, and duration was 40 days. So this is called the artificial aging. Within the 14 days, you can get the aged seed. Before the aging, we have seen that the lipoxygenase enzyme, as we have seen that IR64 have the low lipoxygenase activity, where CR1018 have the high lipoxygenase activity. After that, after storage process, we analyze the MDA in the lipid peroxidation product, reducing sugar, P amino acid, and hydrogen peroxide production. We have measured biochemically. We have seen that the seed which has the high lipoxygenase activity produce high amount of MDA, high amount of reducing sugar, high amount of P amino acid, and high amount of hydrogen peroxide. All are the indication of the seed quality deterioration. But in case of IR64, due to low lipoxygenase activity, this deterioration was minimum. Next, we have seen that the viability, that both non-treated and treated seed, we germinate in the plate in the growth chamber. We have seen that in case of IR64, you can observe this one, the viability was around the 30%, but other seed did not germinate. So from this study, we have seen that the lipoxygenase enzyme has the effect on the seed quality deterioration and viability. Next, I'm covering the lipoxygenase of the rice seed. But what is the next? We don't know what gene is actually involved in the seed quality deterioration. For that purpose, we review the literature. We have seen that the Mizuno et al. 2003, published a paper, plant cell visually, they have seen that armyloxian gene mostly upregulated in the rice embryo compared to the leaf and seed. And they have shown that this lipoxygenase enzyme follow the 9-lipoxygenase pathway. And so this gene may have the role in the seed quality deterioration process. So for that purpose, to silencing for this gene, we clone the, it is the 2.9 kb gene, we clone the partial cDNA from here and clone the p-enter DTOPO vector, and this is our the RNAi vector which was procured from the Germany. Then we after that by LR clonage reaction we subclone in sense antisense orientation in the RNAi vector. In this case, in this RNAi vector, we have used the two promoter. One is the olecin promoter, and another vector we have used the Cambi-35 promoter. It is already known to all of you the Cambi-35 is the constitutive promoter, and another is the olecin promoter. All Cambi-35 promoter was used to downregulate the lipoxygenase activities in the entire plant. But in case of we have used the olecin promoter to downregulate only the lipoxygenase gene in the outer layer of the rice seed, not the entire plant. Osaka et al. 2020 have shown that the GAPSM gas assay, they have shown that the olecin 18 protein actually present in the outer layer of the rice seed. If you see this image, this is the oil layer of the rice seed outer layer, and in the outer layer, the olecin protein is present into the protein level. So if you downregulate the lipoxygenase enzyme with the help of the olecin 18 promoter, then we can only downregulate the lipoxygenase activity in the outer layer of the rice seed, not the entire plant. This was our plant. We have used the two promoter, Cambi-35 promoter and olecin 18 promoter. After vector construction, we transform the gene by ballistic method of transformation. We isolated the immature embryo in the plate. Then after that, we bombard with this both gene one by one, and this is we screen the plant. The hygromycin selection. After that hygromycin selection, we transform the rooting media. After rooting media, we transform selected plant in the greenhouse condition, and we got the seed of the T1 generation. Before that, we screened the T1 generation seed. We have seen that XC9 and XO24 was mostly downregulated. It was observed the biochemical assay, and we have also checked the PC by PCR analysis, the integration of this gene. After that, the T2 generation, we have also screened by enzyme assay. This XC29, 26, and 27 forward line is mostly downregulated. And similarly, we have also proven by the semi-quantitative RTT PCR that the lipoxygenase enzyme was downregulated mostly these two lines. Next, we artificially stored this downregulated line and the controlled rice seed, and then we analyzed biochemical assay. We have seen that the MDA production, protein carbonyl production, lipid hydroxide production was lower in case of downregulated line, where this deterioration was maximum in case of wild type rice due to having the high lipoxygenase activity. So this proved that the lipoxygenase enzyme actually involved in the seed quality deterioration. After that, we have also checked the electrolyte leakage assay by atomic absorption spectroscopy. We have seen that in case of wild type, due to high lipoxygenase activity, the leakage was maximum compared to the downregulated line. We have seen that the seed germination decreased very rapidly in case of wild type seed compared to the downregulated line, and root length and shoot length also decreased very rapidly in case of wild type rapid due to presence of high lipoxygenase activity. We have also germinated the seed. We have seen that seed germination was maximum in soil condition, but no effect was observed in case of transgenic and non-transgenic seed. We have also analyzed the linoleic acid is the substrate for the lipoxygenase enzyme. So we analyzed by GCMS analysis. We have seen that the linoleic acid content was decreased mostly in case of wild type variety compared to the downregulated line. After that, we have analyzed the amino acid content by amino acid analyzer. We have seen that no significant difference was observed in the control and the downregulated line. So this proved that the lipokinase enzymes actually involve the seed quality deterioration and viability also. Next, I'm coming to the golden rice. I think everyone may know about the golden rice, but